What's up guys, GT Gamer here and welcome back to Train Simulator 2017. And this is another live stream. I've turned up my bitrate, which is basically how fast my computer is streaming across the internet. And I'm hoping being the operative word, we can actually get some decent frame rates this time. So we're on the we got an Amtrak F40PH, the California Zephyr, with 9 cars, 2 of which are baggage cars. And that actually confused me because this is not the California Zephyr route. This is the Pacific Surfliner. And we're starting in Fullerton. We're going to stop at Anaheim, Santa Ana, Irvine, and finish in at San Juan Capistrano. And this will be leg 2 of our journey, assuming of course that it actually works this time. So let's start. We're at 2 o'clock and we're basically starting where we left off in the video I've just uploaded on my channel, so this is going to be part 2. So let's start, and I'm just going to quickly have a bit of my drink. Of course, one thing I have to do, which I forgot to do on the last stream, which didn't really work, but I also forgot to unmute my microphone. I muted it, which for me, I've mapped to Shift-M, and I pressed Shift-M again, but it's actually Shift-N to unmute it, so yeah, that was a bit stupid of me. Another thing is, ooh, it still seems to be lagging my stream. That's not good. Let me see if I can quickly fix that. How would I fix that? Settings. Oh, it's going again. This seems to be working a little bit better. Let me just turn up my bitrate. I'm going to go for 7,500. Oh. No, okay, it won't let me do that. I'm going to go for 6,000 then. And I'm going to apply that. Okay. Now it should be a little bit more stable. I forgot what I was saying. So typical of me. What was I saying? I can't remember. Oh yeah, I remember. My microphone is a little bit crackly at the moment, and I have done something to counteract that. I've ordered some microphone wind blockers online, and I'm hoping to get them this month, but the only option was standard delivery, and I'm not sure where they're coming from, so it could take up to a month to deliver, which it's not something I'm keen on, but I'm sure we can push through until then. Well, on first impressions, my frame rate is a lot more stable this time, so that is good. On my live stream, I just wanted to let you guys know, you can do commands. I do have a Nightbot set up, so if you type in the chat, command, exclamation mark, commands, it will show you all of my commands. I'm still setting them up, but I've got most of them mastered. I am hoping eventually to get some kind of coin system introduced, but whether that comes to fruition, I don't know. Also, the chat will appear on screen, so I can just quickly, if I type in a command, so slash commands, there are my commands, and that should hopefully appear on the screen. I'm not certain though. God, this is taking a very long time to load, isn't it? Yep, there they go, they're on screen, perfect. I've only got one monitor, so I've got the game in windowed mode, so I can see the background, and it's just loaded in now. Or at least this black screen. There we go. Let's go outside view. My frame rate is very low. That's probably because I'm streaming. And first thing I want to do, I want to get the HUD up. And let's put the lights on quickly. Ooh, come on, lights. That's the rear lights. Hang on a minute. There, God, they're very dim, aren't they? I was not expecting that. But here is our train, so let me just go into this view. We've got the F40PH locomotive there, And behind we have two baggage cars, and then we have seven. Well, we got six Surfliners, and at the back we have one lounge cafe. And this is a very nice train, I must be fair. And one thing I did want to do, because in the last video I tried to show the inside of this car down here, because for some reason we can't sit in it. But here is the inside, and it is very nice in here. It really, really is. Let's go for our views quickly. So we've got this view. This is the interior view. We've got two different seats. And there's the above, which we can change like that to look at the coupling. And the outside, the external view. And then back inside, that's where we want to be. So let's set off. Let's put the train in forwards, first of all. And then we are going to release the brake. And I'm going to give it one notch of throttle to get going. And once we go... Right, I'm going to give it another notch now. Actually, I'm just going to give it full power, since we've got a speed limit of 79 miles per hour. And while this is accelerating, I'm just going to check my audio, so give me one moment. Right, that's perfect, but it's picking up my game audio in the background, so let me just mute that. I was silly. Right, now let's go. My audio seems okay for now. As I said, I am going to get a wind blocker soon to hopefully counteract the crackling, which I'm experiencing in the background. So we got a speed limit of 55, but it's going back up to 79 in a moment, around this corner. And I'm not entirely sure where that track on the left goes. Does it tell me? Usually it tells me here. Placentia. God, it's so weird. I got my stream open in the background so I can see exactly what I'm doing with like a 10 second delay right behind my video, and it is so trippy. It really, really is. I'm not expecting to have many, if any, viewers at the moment. Like, I'm probably just playing this myself. But hopefully, as time goes on, I'll get more. I have announced it on my channel, but not quite yet. Like, the video where I announced it, it literally just uploaded. So, I do want to do another stream. I did say about 6 on my channel, but I'm probably going to delay that or do a short one. I don't know, because I've got to do something at 7. But I'm going to have a stream at 8 if I don't have one at 6. Coming up on La Palma. Let's have a nice little look. This game is very nice with the external view, especially on this route. This is some very nice scenery right here. Clearly we're in an industrial part of town at the moment, and it is quite nice. It's nice to see my stream actually working for once as well, with like relatively good frame rates. My internet's not the best. I am hoping to get it upgraded, but it's not bad. Like, you can see what's happening. There's a little bit of blur I can see in the background, but other than that, it does seem to be pretty good. This train, I tell you one thing, this train is pretty slow. Is my headlight on? I'm not entirely sure it is. No. So... No, that's the Santa. I didn't want that. That's the tail lights. There's the headlight. That's what I wanted. Perfect. I should probably start paying attention to signals. But I'm just assuming that because this is a free route... No, I don't know why it does that. It shows the light switch. I'm assuming because this is a free roam scenario, we're going to be pretty much on our own out here. Like, at the first part of the journey, there were a few trains, but I think they just spawn in naturally with the route. We got 30 miles to San Juan Capistrano, and our first stop is... What did I say the first stop was? I do have it open. Anaheim, which is not that far away, apparently. My video names in my stream is just uploaded. I got the notification. That's good. I think there's about a 5 second delay on the... Yeah, 5 or 10 second delay on the stream. That's what's tripping me out, because I can see double, but one's behind the other, so I keep looking at the wrong thing, thinking it's my game. It's so silly, but such an easy mistake to make. It's actually working well today. No lag, no muted microphones. I'm pretty impressed with myself. I think I've got this sorted out now, the internet and all that. I'm not sure if we're in a quiet zone, so I'm going to honk for crossings anyway. I'm pretty sure we are in a quiet zone, and I let go of that horn a little bit too early. Got another crossing coming up now. So, the way you use the horn in America is basically you honk two long honks. That sounds so weird. Like, you give it two long blasts before the crossing. Then, not far before the crossing, you give it one short blast, and then one final long blast as you're actually on the crossing. So you can see I'm doing it now. There's the short blast, and then one very long one until you're on the crossing, and then you can let go. And I just saw, we are in a quiet zone, I just saw the, what's it called, the speedboard. Yeah, we don't have to honk for it, because as I said, we're in a quiet zone. I'm going to have to pay attention to that, though. I'm going to try and look for any places where... any signs to tell us we've left the quiet zone. This train is ridiculously slow. Like, we're only... it's full throttle since the station, and we're going 46 miles per hour. Let's see, so you can jog faster than that. Coming up on a speed limit of 70, which we don't have to worry about because we can't hit that for some reason. Oh, I blasted the horn then, but I forgot we're in a quiet zone. I do love the scenery though on this route. Like, it's so nice. So, it's spent a lot of time, someone spent a lot of time making this look the way it does. Look at that, that is awesome. Our beautiful, beautiful train. So nice. Back inside. Going over a nice little road here, which looks like quite a busy road. Now there's absolutely nobody on it, because RIP Train Simulator. Got another little crossing. There is like some kind of fog effect in the distance, that's odd. Like a heat effect, like you know when it's wavy when it's really hot? I can see that for some reason. I'm not sure if that's meant to be there, or if it's because I'm playing on 720. Either way. Right. Oh, we're coming up on Anaheim now, which is our stop. So I'm going to idle the throttle, and I'm going to give us 13% brake, I think. We got just over half a mile, but we're only going 42 miles per hour, so we should make it just fine. Excuse me. I'm gonna honk my horn as I go into the station, because I think that's what you're meant to do, irrelevant of quiet zones and whatnot. So I'm gonna do that, just to be sure. If there is something I'm missing, guys, feel free to let me know in the chat or in the comments when I upload this on YouTube. But as far as I know, I've got this pretty much mastered. That's not true, I'm pretty sure I haven't, but you know. I think we can release the brake a little bit now. That was actually quite a nice slowing speed though. I'm going to release the brake at 20 actually. just going to pull in at about 20 miles per hour. I've got no dropped frames, that is nice. Yeah, last time I dropped frames, which is the amount of frames that didn't get streamed, was like 91%, I think it was at one point. It was just not good. And it's just because my bitrate was extremely low. At the moment, I've got zero dropped frames, so I think I've got it mastered with my bitrate. I'm aiming to stop at the end of the platform at Anaheim. Anaheim's quite a big city, if I remember right. I'm pretty sure the Mythbusters went there at one point. I used to love Mythbusters when I was a kid. Right, we might need... Yeah, we're going to need to accelerate a little bit, so I'm just going to give us one notch of throttle, just to get us to the end of the platform. And release the throttle. We are coming in a little bit slower than I hoped, but, you know... should be okay. In fact, we may need... yeah, let's just give it a little bit more throttle once again. Let's go outside view so we can see where we're stopping. And about here. Just pop the brake on. Perfect. And as soon as we stop, I'm going to press T to let the passengers out. Oh my god, we're actually rolling backwards. So I'm going to press T to let the passengers out. And we're going to have a look at our lovely train at Anaheim. That does look really nice. This is so much better than Trains 2006. Yeah, that was my first train sim. It was 100% rubbish. But it was a little bit easier to use, I will admit. But then, equally, there was no controller support, so swings and roundabouts. Either way, the doors are shut, we can now set off. I'm just going to give it a boot full throttle, to get us going. Ow. Just banged my leg. This train accelerates from like 0 to 20 pretty quick. Then after that, it just slows the hell down. It really does, that's quite unusual. Off we go, 25. So I had my first driving lessons, and that's a whistle board there, so we're out of the quiet zone now. I had my first driving lesson today, it was so nice. I can't wait to pass. They reckon I can pass around February, because I can't book in any tests until then, because all the spaces are booked up. Which kind of sucks, because I did want to learn to drive, like, in a couple of weeks. Because, realistically, I need a car for work. So, yeah, it's not as good as I wanted it to be, but either way, I'll be on the road soon. Accidentally let go of the horn a little bit there. Got a 35 mile per hour limit coming up, so at about, I was thinking 38 miles per hour, I'm just going to release the throttle and let's coast a little bit. So yeah, I'm thinking about 38, or maybe, nah, as we go through the next signal, I'm going to release the throttle. So here comes the signal, and release the throttle, and we need to press the horn down for this crossing coming up now. Not sure why there's a 35 limit, we're probably going across a junction or something. Maybe a very sharp turn. A lot of level, well, grade crossings. I am going to try and use the American terminology. There's a lot of grade crossings around here. I have noticed that. What is this station coming up? Is it somewhere we need to stop? Orange. Right, no, we don't need to stop at Orange. I think it's just called Orange. That's an unusual name. Yeah, we're not stopping at Orange. The next stop is, I believe, Santa Ana. Let me just check that. Yes, yeah, Santa Ana, then Irvine, and then San Juan Capistrano. God, I love saying that. That's such a fun thing to say. Right, we have slowed down way too much, so I'm just going to give it full throttle right now. Because we're not going to break this speed limit, and as I said, it's because of this sharp turn up here, which I think is followed by a junction. I think this is a triangle junction. Yep. What's this stop round the corner? That's important. That might be... No, that's orange, isn't it? Yeah, we're coming up on orange. I'm pretty sure there's a county in California called Orange County. Perhaps that is... I might be wrong about that, but perhaps that's named after this town we're in. I'm assuming we're in some kind of town or suburb called Orange. That is an unusual name. What should we name our town? Pass me that orange. That's what we'll call it. That's how I imagine the conversation went, probably. I think I guessed that throttle perfectly, because we'll be hitting 35 just as the back of the train goes through the speed board. That is perfect. I forgot to whistle for that. Grade crossing, but I am going to give us two blasts as we're going through this station, like just before, as I just did. And this is orange, apparently. Hello, orange. Those cement mixers are quite common in California, apparently. I've seen about 12 of them on the journey. Oh, this is just going to be non-stop blasting our horn from here on everything. Excuse me. Probably should mute my microphone. I am going to try and learn to mute my microphone when I sneeze and stuff like that. It is not a habit I'm accustomed to, because I never used to record using my PC. I used to record audio on my phone. That's why I can never live stream up until now. Oh wow, we've got a 40 limit coming up. Not sure why there's a 40 limit, but I'm just going to keep it in 25% throttle. It's probably because this corner is quite steep or something like that, quite sharp. Where are we? Not really, that's not a very sharp corner. Where's our stop? Show task is Y, so we're stopping here, that's our final destination. Ah, I remember San Juan Capistrano now. That is the station, because I thought it was odd. That station has a point halfway through the platform with a divergent track, which I thought was pretty unusual. That is cool, that's how I remember it. Ah, that's pretty cool detail. I've never seen that before. I've seen platforms with points in it, but that's just if the platform's split in two. That was the fastest horn blast ever. But yeah, it's unusual to have two tracks like them with a station on the point. This is a very nice area. What I'm trying to work out is these, is that the front or the back garden? Because the driveways don't seem to go anywhere. They got garages with driveways going absolutely nowhere, straight into a fence or onto a footpath. Either way, this is very, very nice. Wow. That must get annoying if you live right by there, though. All these trains honking as they go past. Unless we're in a quiet zone. I haven't seen any signs, but then I can't exactly claim to have been paying attention. Because of the nature of the area we're in, it's very built up. I'm going to assume that it's a quiet zone from here on out. If I miss the signs, I'm just going to use my noggin to work out whether it's a quiet zone or not. Did we just go for a red light? My god, I hope not. We're coming up on Santa Ana. Santa Ana is a very nice area, apparently. It certainly looks like it. I'm just going to coast into the station. We are going uphill a little bit. I think we're going uphill. It might be downhill. No, that's downhill we're going at the moment. At a 0.6% gradient. Not that much. My plan is to just coast into the station. And hopefully, it'll work. I must say, I'm impressed that my internet's been holding up this well. My CPU's not very active, only 45%, but I'm impressed. We're going 60 frames a second and it's holding up just fine at 6,000 kilobytes a second, which is the maximum you can stream on Steam. Right, we are going very slow, so I'm going to need to speed up a little bit. I'm just going to go 50% throttle, I think. One thing I don't like about this train, which is different to others that I've noticed, is in others you just have to tap and it'll go to the next throttle setting, or tap the other way and it'll go back. With this, you have to hold it until it goes into the throttle setting. I don't like that very much. It'd be nice if I could just tap and go down a notch. But then, it's a nice train either way, so I can't exactly moan about it. Alright, 20 miles an hour, coming up on Santa Ana. Just give it a few blasts before we go into the station and as we're going across this crossing. I did see a whistle board back there, but I think that's for passing through trains, and we're going too slowly to honk that far ahead of the platform. Not unless I wanted to hold the horn down for about a minute. God, that's lovely detail. Look at all those yellow cars in a row. Modelling era much. God, look at this. Wow. Dad, can I move to Santa Ana? Like, seriously, I would live by here. I would live in this flat, this station. That is really nice. Like, seriously. That's so cool. I want to live there. That's like a billionaire's villa. That is so nice. Look at the stairs going down. That is cool as. I'm not going to finish that sentence. That's really awesome though. Very long platform as well. Either that or we're just going incredibly slowly. I think I know which one it is. I'm just going to give it a bit of power, two notches of power, just to get into the station. And come on, train. I'm being very impatient, but I know if I speed up, I'll just shoot the platform, just overshoot the platform. Right, I'm going to apply the brake now. Perfect. And press T to let the passengers out. Let's see if the doors actually open. Yes, they do. Again on the train. This is the sleeping car. Ah, I missed the train. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. I'm going to have to wait for the next one. Didn't want that view. That's the one I wanted. Actually, no, I go an outside view, because this is such a nice station, like, damn. Brake off, throttle on, and off we go again. Wheel slip, V? Is it V? No, it's not V. What's the sander button? Are our windscreen wipers on? Why the heck are our windscreen wipers on? That's weird. Oh well. Right, we can turn the sand off now. It is odd though, the power distribution on this train, how it can go like from 0 to 25 really quickly, then after that it just kind of slows down. I think you need some better gearing or something. Not sure if trains have gears, but you know. Another have a busy road, Santa Ana Main Street or something. Right, what is our next stop? Our next stop is Irvine. It's the last one before our final stop. So next stop, Irvine. Hang on a minute. I was looking at it thinking that's not right. Look at this. This is just a piece of track that serves absolutely no purpose. There's no way to get onto that piece of track there. What about this one next to it? Also grayed out. Right, you can get onto that one. There's a truck stuck on the crossing. That is terrible driving. You're crushing someone. What the fuck? I didn't mean to swear. Sorry, there might be kids watching, but what the hell? That makes no sense. Ah well, not my problem. Coming up on a 90-mile-an-hour zone, that's the fastest I've seen so far on this route. Oh, I should probably be honking for this crossing. one last one as we cross. Of course, nobody waiting because the main roads are about as busy as a country lane in this game. But there's not much I can really do about that. Got another whistle board here. Second delay is so trippy when you've got the stream running in the background. It really is. It's like, what? I'm playing twice. God, level crossing central here, or grade crossing, I must remember to use the American terminology. I do apologise, I am British in case you can't tell by my accent. Not the most British accent, but then I am Welsh, not English, so you can expect a bit of a Welsh accent in there somewhere. God, I love Wales. We have the best flag in the world, and I refuse to accept any different. It's got a Welsh dragon on it. Like, you cannot not like a Welsh dragon, seriously. Big red dragon on a green background, so nice. Anyway, I've gone a bit off tangent now. I'm very good at that. Talk about one thing, then just randomly switch topics. We've got a nice little storm drain on the left here. That's the thing with California. As far as I know, and what the TV seems to be telling me, is that California's weather is a little bit like Spain, in that it will be 14 degrees Celsius every day. And then, every now and again, you'll just get a day where all of the rain comes at once, and you'll get, like, inches and inches of rain, and everything will flood, it'll come down off the mountains, the storm drains will be full, and then the sun will come back out and dry it up again. Like, I can't imagine having weather like that, because I live somewhere where it's basically always rainy. Like, it's constantly raining in Britain. So, it would just be a little bit weird, I think, if the weather was like 40 degrees, 45 degrees, 40 degrees, 40 degrees, 45 degrees, 10 degrees, well, actually no, it's probably still 40 degrees, just with boiling hot rain. But I can't imagine living somewhere like that. I think we're leaving Santa Ana now. And if I remember right, the track speed limit stays at 90 for quite a while now. And for some reason my frame rate is being quite slow on my stream. I can see that a little bit now. I'm hoping that levels out. We've still got a good streaming strength. But I don't know, maybe... I know what it is. Give me a second. It is because... if I remember right, I'm streaming in... Where is it? Video... I can't change it. Damn. It's lagging because I'm trying to stream in 1080. There's nothing I can do to fix that either. Without stopping the stream and starting it again. Right, I'm gonna do that, guys, because that lag is annoying. So let me just quickly fix that and the stream will start again in a, like, literally a moment. Right, let me try this now. I do apologise for this, guys. But I can't have it where it's zoomed in, now looks a bit stupid. Right, yep, that's exactly how I wanted it. Now, how's the frame? The frame rate is beautiful, it's brilliant. Thank God for that. It's because I was streaming in full HD, which Steam doesn't allow. Anyway, this is Tustin Station. Probably should have honked onto that, but obviously I was concentrating on something else. That's where we're going. But yeah, I do apologise for that, guys. I'm going to try and remember to do that before every stream. So, just ignore what happened, and let's get back to the journey. I'm glad I fixed that, though. It looks so much smoother and nicer now. I'm going to have to set up profiles where I can just choose whether I want a recording profile, which is 1080, or a streaming profile, which will be 720. Choose that in the future. Starting to get out more into the wilderness rather than the suburbs now. Yep, when the camera spins round, it's absolutely fine on the stream. I'm happy with that now. So, let's continue the journey. And the next stop is Irvine, California. Storm drain just randomly ends, then there's a ditch where there's a highway, then another storm drain. I bet this gets flooded like mad. Ooh, there's an ambulance there. Wondering if he's going to save someone. Can you guys see that on the third car, the first passenger car? It looks like it's been on fire. Like, there's a black streak on it, that is weird. What the hell? I've never seen that before. Yeah, there is. That must be the smoke from the engine. I've never ever seen that before. That is such a cool detail. That really is. Extremely bit straight of track. That didn't even make any sense. I'm not even Englishing right now. We've got an extremely straight bit of track now, which if we had a fast train we could go like 90 miles an hour, but we have a very very heavy, very very slow train, and we're going up a gradient of 1.2%, which is pretty damn steep, so don't expect 90 miles an hour anytime soon. Funny, I thought California was pretty flat. It is lovely though. I can't wait to go to California. I don't know when it's happening. I've just planned it for some time in the next couple of years. Probably not 2018. I don't know. See where the future takes me. That's the thing with life, you never know what's going to happen next. Just having a lovely little bit of a look round. It's a shame that the hills in the distance are a little bit crap. There needs to be a little bit more detail over there. But I get why they did that, is to make your frame rates a bit better, but either way. But the trees down here are very nice. This does look very California down this part. If I zoom the camera down, so it's looking just at the part close to the track, that is so California, it's not even funny. The baggage cars are a little bit odd. We don't really have them in the UK. Like, if you have baggage, you just take it with you and put it on the seat next to you or under the seat or something. Keep it on your lap if you have to. We have, like, little things at the end of each carriage, like by the door where you can put suitcases and big stuff. But we don't have baggage cars, I've never seen that. I wonder if it's the same in America, but then they carry, like, I don't know, mail and stuff. Like, they act as a freight car as well. Possibly. I don't know the answer to that. I've never been on an American train. I've never been to America, so someone will have to let me know about that, because, I don't know, I've never seen that before. We don't really have that in the UK. Oh, God, I love it. An ad for a train in Train Simulator. Hello, San Diego. That's the train we're on, which is in a different locomotive. I probably should have chose the, what's it called? The P42, I think it is. The one that you're meant to use. But I got confused between the California Zephyr and the Pacific Surfliner. That's why we're using this train. Might being the operative word, I might swap over at San Luis Obispo. That would make it a bit meh, though. I don't know, maybe one day. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep this train for the entire journey, because there's not much left now. But then, one day soon, I'm going to stream the entire length of the journey, and I'm going to use the right locomotive, the right train, and it's going to be set up all nice and beautiful. What the hell is that? It's like someone stuck a massive sewing pin in the map. Why is that? Can we go over to that? What the hell is that? It is literally like someone stuck a pin in the map. Is that an airport? Ah, it's probably a weather radar or something. I'm pretty sure that's meant to be an airport. Where's our train? Is that it? Yep, there it is. Oh, that's weird. There's no LOD on the baggage cars, so they disappeared. And any second now, there they go, they spawn in. Right, we're coming up on Irvine, California. So I'm just going to release the throttle, and hopefully we can coast in, but this train does like to lose speed pretty fast. Is that another train in the distance? No, of course not. Why would it be? Like, this game has AI traffic. Silly me. 0.4 of a mile away. I think we'll be able to coast in at this speed. If you're wondering why the audio dies and the mouse appears on screen, it's because I'm muting my microphone to cough or have a drink or something. Nice bit of my vape. God, I love them vapes. Vape Nation. I used to have Heisenberg, which is like a mint berry flavour, in my vape. But recently I found one called Red A, and it is so nice. It makes the room smell nice that you're in. Like, people walk in the room and go, that's a nice smell. What is that? It's just, it's just my vape. It's so nice, though. It's aniseed, menthol, and a couple of berries. It's really, really nice. I'm going to give it some throttle to go through this station. What is it with American stations and really nice walkways? Like, going over the platforms. Every station we've gone to so far has had a really nice walkway. But look at that. That must have cost a lot of money to install, and there's nothing around here. That is odd. There's a big multi-story car park, I think that is, but that's about it. And brake. Oh god, we're not going to stop. Just about making this. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. And do you know what I'm going to do now? Open the doors! I love how it's actually animated that the doors open. Right, now we're going to catch our train because we missed it last time. We're going to go in here. Where do I go? Over here, straight into a purple door. How the hell do you get upstairs? I have no idea. But you can walk through the carriages. Coach dorm. Let's run. gotta be a little bit silly every now and again. Right, brakes off and full power, fast as we can, to our final stop of this stream slash video, because this is probably going to get uploaded to YouTube. If you guys want to see and check out my YouTube channel, I'll put a link in the chat now. All you do to get that is type YouTube, exclamation mark YouTube in the chat, and it should pop up, and you can just click that little link. Yep, there it goes, it's on screen now as well. Yeah, I've got a lot of commands you can type into the chat, and as I said before, if you type exclamation mark commands, it'll pop up. It's actually in the chat right now, so if you guys want to check out anything, there's all my commands. You can find my Facebook, my YouTube, you can see the title and all that nonsense. God, this is barren around here. This is more like Montana than California, jeez. Well, it's not like Montana because there's actually hills on this map. Montana's just absolutely flat until you reach the Rockies. It's a very flat expanse of North America, with the exception of like Colorado and the Rockies and a few mountain ranges here and there. The Appalachian Trail. Apparently that's a very nice walk. It's a shame there's no AI traffic. That's my biggest thing about this game that I don't like. We've got 11.4 miles to go. You can see our destination over there. And we're probably going to have an average speed of 42 miles an hour because this train is crap at accelerating. I'm assuming, because I didn't build this train set, it's one that's in the game. This is like the California Zephyr train set. I'm assuming it's a very slow route, since this train's not very fast. Ah, no, we go. Perhaps I'm just doing something wrong. That's more than likely. I'm not very good at reading instructions. I just try and work out how to drive them. That looks like a supermarket, but there. So this is probably Santa Ana. No, not Santa Ana. Irvine. Because that station seemed pretty barren, and Irvine's a big place, I thought. So this is probably Irvine. Perhaps the station's just a little bit in the sticks or something. Do you know, I got absolutely no plans for today. I was going to just edit the video, like this video, because I'm recording it as well, and upload that to YouTube, but it is tempting to just keep streaming and go all the way down. And then my stream at 6 could be like a ride on the TGV or something. That might be quite cool. I'm absolutely loving the graphics though, the scenery. It's just a shame that it's 720 on Twitch and it's a little bit blurry, because on mine it's so nice. Like, the anti-aliasing is a bit rubbish, they need to work on that, but the actual scenery is really nice. It is a little bit shame that it's slightly blurry on Twitch, but then there's nothing really I can do about that unless I become a Twitch partner, which I can't do yet because I'm nowhere near big enough. What are those lights in the distance? I keep forgetting which button it is on the keyboard to go free camera. That is a baseball pitch. There's two of them, actually. And here's Irvine. I'm assuming it's Irvine. There's the track. It's quite a nice place. Very nice, actually. And we've reached the limit of the camera. So this is how fast we're going if we was on the train. Guy, this even looks very, very slow. Like, jeez. We definitely need a different locomotive next time we do this, where we do the full length of it. Should I just stream the entire length and then stream back? It is tempting. I've got plenty of room on my hard drive to record this to. I might just do that. What do you guys reckon? I'm just trying to think. What time is it? Do I have time to do that? 12 o'clock. I am thinking I should just... I got a few options. Either I just don't stream the next one, I edit this video and put it on YouTube. Or, because this scenario is going to finish as soon as I get into San Juan Capistrano. So I could then pop out, come back in, and stream from San Juan Capistrano to San Diego. Or, I could go down, I could exit this when we reach San Juan Capistrano. I love saying that. And get the better locomotive, and then do the full route all the way from San Diego to LA. What should I do? I genuinely don't know. I don't know how long that route is though. Probably a good hour and a half. Okay, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the last leg, because I'm doing this in three sections. I'm going to do the last section straight after this. And then I am going to, at whatever time I stream later, when I was planning on doing the big stream, I'm going to record from San Diego to LA in a faster train. Yeah, I think that sounds like a plan. Of course, now we're going really fast as we're coming up to the last stop because we're going downhill. That's blowing brilliant. So, like, all route, I've wanted to go like 70 miles an hour. Finally, as we're coming up to the end of the thing, we go downhill and can actually accelerate to that. Such karma. So yeah, after this I'm going to record the last leg of the journey, I think. God, we're going blisteringly fast now. Wow, I've never been so fast. Not on this train, anyway. This is a very slow train. They should have put at least a double header on you so it could accelerate faster. Another set of baseball pitches. And some, what's that, football? I believe that's American football grounds. Or as they would call it, football. Tennis there. Yep, that is, I believe that's American football with the big rugby post things. Wait, where's the track? I'm going to get a nice view of the train passing. Probably should have turned the HUD off, but can't now. As if I was a train spotter. There it goes. Give it a nice little honk as it goes past. 70 miles an hour. Jeez, we're speeding like mad. We must be mad going that fast. Jeez, this train's so crap. Yeah, I'm going to use... I think it's called the P42. I'm not sure. It's got another name. What's its nickname? Genesis. The Genesis. That's the one. Been trying to think of that all day. Jeez. Yeah, I'm gonna do the Genesis after this. I think that's gonna be awesome. Coming up on Laguna Niguel. We're not scheduled to stop there, so I'm just gonna blast straight through the station at our record-breaking speed. Give it a nice little honk as we go through, because we have to. Literally just realised we haven't had a great crossing in ages. They were becoming so common at one point that there was one every train length, pretty much. What's that on the right? A quarry? It's weird how it's fenced off. Perhaps it's not. Do have a lovely another storm drain there. They are so common in California. I've never even seen a storm drain. Apparently they're very common in California. When we're half mile out, I'm going to give it a nice honk. stop there. And then the people on the platform know, hey, there's a train approaching, and he's a madman, he's speeding. I like this speed. I like this town as well. Another nice little building there. This is such a nice area, California is. Oh, bridge over a train track over a highway. That's pretty cool. So kind of flying junction for the highway, it looks like. Yep, that's probably quite a busy junction in real life. Of course, now we're down to single track. That's how you know we're getting fairly close to the station. Now I'd imagine that's a pretty busy junction in real life there. With a nice little country road running alongside. It's very nice, look at the hills there. This is a really nice area. I want to live here. Long sweeping curve. Onto probably another ridiculously long straight. Yep, there it is. They like this straight track in America, don't they? Oh no, we're coming up on a 60 zone. Gonna have to lose this madman speed. Oh, we're coming up on the station anyway. Okay. I'll start braking when we're about a mile out from the platform. This train does seem to have pretty good brakes, that's one thing it has going for it. So, swings and roundabouts. I'd rather good acceleration and not very good brakes though. Because with the HUD on, you can see when you're about 2 miles from the station at high speed. Right, gonna start reducing the throttle now. Assuming we're in a quiet zone because there's a lot of residential houses nearby. And I'm gonna start braking. Around 40%, I reckon. As you know, that's a bit steep, so around 27%. Would you guys like to live here? I would. I really would. This looks really nice. Look at that, someone had a pool there. And it's actually reflective in the game, that's a cool detail. I don't think we're going to slow down in time, so 40% brake. Look at that, we went an entire journey with no dropped frames. So, yep, that's pretty damn good. Hopefully one day I'll become partnered with Steam so I can have better definition. Hopefully. You guys can help me by doing that if you want, by giving me a quick follow. That would be nice. I wanna... My goal is 1,000 followers by the end of, like, I don't know, by summer next year, maybe. Right, our brakes are on a little bit too sharp at the moment. You'll see what I mean now with a point halfway along the station. We have a yellow over red, which means we're cleared to pull into the station, I think. To let the people know we're coming. In. Is it just me or is there a level crossing, a grade crossing on the station? Yeah, there is. Huh. Never seen that before either. No, come on, we need to stop. The brakes... Ah, we're gonna overshoot. Ooh, this is gonna be close. Come on, stop! Ah, just overshot that. Son of a biatch. Oh well, either way, that was a nice journey, guys. And I'm going to come straight back on in about 5 minutes to stream the rest of it. So, sit back, and chill out, and I will see you in 5 minutes. So just wait for the little notification pop-up. I need to open the doors. Yeah, well done, you've reached the end of this quick drive scenario. So guys, make sure you stick around, and I'll see you in about 5 minutes. Okay guys, so I'm casually hosting Squirrel in the background, even though he's not live, he's doing a vodcast. But, unfortunately, You can see here, I'm on the home screen of the quick drive on Train Simulator 2017. And for some reason, I don't know why, it won't let me drive from San Luis Obispo to San Diego. It will let me do it the other way, but... not San Luis Obispo, sorry. San Juan Capistrano. And it won't let me go. It won't let me choose it as a starting station. So, the problem is, I could do it in reverse, but that would kind of... It would not only be bad for this scenario, because it'd be kind of incomplete. It wouldn't make much sense, like, chronologically. But also, the stream I'm planning to do soon is the one I've set up here, which would be the F40PHI... or the Genesis, if I could find it, from San Diego to Los Angeles. So basically what we've just done, but the full route in the opposite direction. But for some strange reason, it won't let me start in San Juan Capistrano. So I'm going to call it here, and I'm going to do a live stream later at either 6 or 8, I'm not entirely sure. But... unfortunately, I can't finish this scenario, and I'm not going to do the Pacific Surfliner later, because I'd be, like, I don't know, doing the same route twice in the same day. It'd just be a bit boring, so I'm going to save that for another time. I might do a bit of World of Tanks later, I don't know yet, I haven't decided. But make sure you come back for that, and I'm sorry I couldn't complete this route. In the future, I will. I'll just have to use a map editor or drive from when the other station's there. But I'm hoping to have that done soon, and I do apologise that I couldn't do it now. So thanks for watching either way, like regardless, and I will see you next time, so make sure you come back for that. Peace out, guys.